You are about to learn about something that's pretty cool called probability. 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 Probability is the chance of something happening. That's pretty simple. Probability is the chance of something happening. I'll show you how it works using coins. Yeah, coins are fun. Especially to spin. Okay, look at this spinning penny, and it might look like the penny's alone. Don't worry, the penny has coin friends. Let's say you have these five coins, three pennies, one dime, and one nickel. You decide to randomly pick a coin to spin on a table. This is going to be a totally random pick. You aren't going to peek. If you randomly pick one of these coins, how likely are you to pick a penny? That's a good question. Well, more than half of these coins are pennies. So the answer is likely. You will likely pick a penny. Likely means there's a big chance. Okay, how likely are you to pick a dime? Well, that's different. There's only one dime. Only one out of the five coins is a dime. How likely are you to pick a dime? The answer is unlikely. Unlikely meaning there's a chance, but you probably won't. You are unlikely to pick a dime. Well, let's not leave out the nickel. How likely are you to pick a nickel? Well, let's think about it. There's just one nickel out of five coins, just like we had with the dime, which means there's a chance you might pick the nickel, but you are unlikely to pick it. The answer is unlikely. You are unlikely to pick a nickel. All right, here's another situation. Say you are at a baseball game and you found some pennies. Four pennies, in fact. Just to be silly, you decide to randomly pick a coin in your pocket to see which kind you pick, even though all four coins are pennies. How likely are you to pick a penny? Well, you have to pick a penny, right? Because that's the only option. You are certain to pick a penny. The answer is certain. In probability, we use the word certain to mean there's no chance of anything else happening. You are certain to pick a penny, 100%. Now let's look at a completely different scenario. Say I want a green balloon because green is my favorite color in the whole world, which it actually is. I don't know why, it just is. Green has always been my favorite color. All right. So I go to a store to try to buy a green balloon, but I don't know they only have red and blue balloons. All the other balloons are sold out. How likely am I to buy a green balloon at this store? Well, there aren't any green balloons, so there is no chance. It is impossible to buy a green balloon from this store on that day. Impossible is the word used in probability when there is no chance of that outcome happening. I can't buy a green balloon from this store right now. It's impossible. I'm just kidding. It might be impossible to buy a green balloon from this store today, but there's no way I'm giving up. I can go somewhere else and look for a green balloon, or come back here another day once they get more green balloons in. All right, so probability is the chance of something happening. There are words we use to describe the probability of an event. There's certain, that means you have a 100% chance. It will happen for sure. There's likely, that means you have a big chance. There's a big chance it will happen. Then there's unlikely, that means there's a little chance of it happening. And lastly, the term impossible, meaning zero chance. Just like there was zero chance of me getting a green balloon at the store that day, that does not mean it will always be impossible. In fact, the probability or chance of something happening can change. Maybe you find another coin at the baseball game, a nickel this time, Or maybe a delivery truck arrives and suddenly I do have a chance of getting a green balloon at that store. Okay, now it's time for a probability quiz. I need your help. Pretend you are at a movie theater. You've been picking up coins you found along the way. 7 in all. 4 nickels, 2 dimes, and 1 penny. While you wait for the movie to start, you pick coins randomly without looking. How likely are you to pick a nickel? How likely are you to pick a nickel? Likely. Correct. You are likely to pick a nickel. More than half of the coins are nickels. You have a big chance of picking a nickel. That means it is likely. You are doing great. All right, how likely are you to pick a penny? A penny. How likely are you to pick a penny? Unlikely. You are unlikely to pick a penny. There's a chance you could pick a penny, but it's just a little chance. Unlikely. What's next? How likely are you to pick a dime? A dime. How likely are you to pick a dime? Unlikely. Yep, you are unlikely to pick a dime. With only 2 of the 7 coins being dimes, there's only a small chance you'll pick a dime. Unlikely. Okay, here's the final question. How likely are you to pick a quarter? A quarter? How likely are you to pick a quarter? It's impossible, yes. If you only have these 7 coins, it's impossible to pick a quarter because none of them are quarters. It's impossible. But remember, if you find a quarter later on, add that to your collection and play the same game, the probability would change. It wouldn't be impossible anymore, but it would be unlikely. So, probability is the chance of something happening. There are words we use to describe the probability of an event. There's certain, that means you have a 100% chance. It will happen for sure. There's likely, that means you have a big chance. There's a big chance it will happen. Then there's unlikely, that means there's a little chance of it happening. And lastly, the term impossible, meaning zero chance. Just like there was zero chance of me getting a green balloon at the store that day. That does not mean it will always be impossible. In fact, the probability or chance of something happening can sometimes change. You did such a wonderful job learning about probability, the chance of something happening. I think Mr. Whiskers is likely to agree. No, he's certain to agree. 100%.
100%, Mr. Whiskers.
You watched this video to the end, which is so cool. Real quick, as we wrap this up, if you have not subscribed to our channel, if you'll take a moment to do that, we have so many learning videos and we want you to be in the loop with new uploads. So click subscribe if that sounds like a blast. We hope you had a fun time. Thank you for watching. We want to give a massive thank you to our patrons. You can learn how to support us and get Homeschool Pop tattoos, so fashionable, on our website, homeschoolpop.com, or by clicking the link below this video. That would be really cool. You know you're awesome. We know you're awesome. And we're excited to see you on the next learning video.